IDP camps have been dismantled, but there are still around 27 or 24 IDP camps still there.
No, 18
IDP camps. If Myanmar can resettle some people from the IDP camps, then the trust will be built up. So about the trust building, two things is most important. One, taking the zero line people, and the resettlement of the people staying in the IDP camps. If these two things are taken, then the trust will be built up. Trust will not be built up with sort of automatically. Because we have the breach of trust already. And even about the infrastructure development, Myanmar has made some houses, prefabricated houses. They have received some houses from India and China also. And as per our information, around 2,000 houses in total, or something like that. But if the people go back to Myanmar, as per our estimation, there will be around 200,000 houses for this displaced people. So 2,000 versus 200,000 doesn't match. So how many people they can afford if they start going there? That's always a question. So that's why they have the doubt that if they go back, they will stay longer period in the IDP camps, in the reception centers. So I think there should be more houses to also build the trust among themselves. So this is the basically, and one more thing about the verified list, because we have already passed through 106,000 list of the names of the displaced persons to Myanmar government. And so far, we have received around less than 10,000 verified list. And there is a tricky issue in the verified list. One thing from a person, because there is a family unit, is very important. If we want to do the repatriation, we need the family unit verified as a whole. But what we see, from 5 persons in the family, 2 are verified and 5 or 3 are not found in the household list. So that creates a problem. So the number is increasing, but the family unit is not increasing as well. That's why it hampers the repatriation process. Because if I say, so 3 persons you are verified, you go, and 2 persons will remain in Bangladesh, they will never go back. So this is a very strong impediment of these people not to go. So I think Myanmar also take care of, because how a person, when 3 persons of the family are verified and 2 persons are not verified and they are not found in the household list, I'm not sure actually. So that's the main reason also hampering our repatriation process. And trust building, the third one that I missed up. So I told about two things for trust building. I missed one thing, now I'm telling it. So zero line people relocation and then IDP camps resettlement. Third point is to go and see visit, because if Myanmar is ready to take them back anytime, because Myanmar always said that they can take back these people anytime they want. But the thing is that we are requesting Myanmar government always to have a go and see visit. So take some of us, not exactly that Bangladesh should go, but international, basically the organization who is working, UNHCR, UNDP, and some persons from Rohingya community, they can go and see in person what is there. Otherwise, they will never believe what you say. So they will have to see in person, because the trust that you had, it has already broken. So build up the trust, go and see, visit is a must. At least some of them should go there. I think even our friend from Chinese Embassy, he is also here. So they also took some initiatives also, and they proposed something 1+1=2. That means one person will go and see and give us the information for one person here. So that means the go and see visit is a must. Someone will go see in person what is there, the infrastructure development and other issues. Then they will inform the
ကျွန်တော်တို့ကလည်းဒီနေ့ကျွန်တော်မြန်မာနိုင်ငံပေါ်မြန်မာလူမျိုးတွေပြည်ပြည်သားတွေနဲ့အားလုံးတွေ့ဆုံနေရတဲ့အတူမျိုးမျိုးယူပြီးတော့ကြောင်းပြောရပ်လိုပါတယ်ခင်ဗျာလူကလည်းဒီနေ့ကမှာကျွန်တော်တို့ကတူဆုံးတွေ့တယ်အဲ့ဒီမှာလည်းကျွန်တော်တော်များများဆွေးနွေးခဲ့ကြတယ်ဒါရလောင်းနဲ့ဆက်ဆံမယ်ဆိုပြီးကျွန်တော်ပြောချင်ပြောခဲ့ကြတယ်ဒါရလောင်းဆိုတာက လူတို့ဆိုရဲ့လူမျိုးလုံးမဲ့ကောင်းဆောင်မှုမဲ့လူတို့ရှင်နဲ့ဘုဘက်ကလူတပွင့်နဲ့ဂျာဂမ်ဗီဒီယာဒါဆိုတဲ့လူတို့ဆိုနဲ့ခြေချနေတာသေးချအရှင်နဲ့ထိုင်နေရတဲ့ဟာပဲဖြစ်ပါတယ်ဒီလိုလူအုပ်ကြီးနဲ့နေရာချင်းချင်းပြန့်ပြန့်မှာတော်တော်များများဆွေးနွေးရတာအရှုပ်တလီမဖြစ်တာဖြစ်ပါတယ်အဲဒါကြောင့်မို့လို့ First of all, ladies and gentlemen, nice to meet you the next day. The 1982 citizenship law marked the legalization of a border and ongoing national campaign to denuclearize the Rohingya, which include removing them from the Myanmar soil. and destroying them as ethnic group. This process began under the military rule, General Nehru, and continues until today. Even in this process include the military operation known as Nagami in 1978, which reported result in an estimated 250,000 Rohingya being driven out into neighboring Bangladesh, and many being declared illegal migrants. Then, 1989 citizen security exercise, which Rohingya National Registration Certificate, the only made proof of the citizenship. At that time, were removed. Military and civilian campaigns against them in the 1990s, and the violence against Rohingya in Arakane state since June 2012 in Tango, which has led to mass displacement and further disproportionate restriction for the Rohingya. Revisions of the 1982 citizenship law need to place in a much broader set to reform aims at protecting Rohingya and religious minority in Myanmar, reversing the trends of increasing racial, religious hatred and violence against in Myanmar, only for the Rohingya. The 1982 citizenship law deprived the Rohingya of the citizenship in Myanmar. Under this law, full citizenship is primarily based on member of the national race, which were considered by the state to have settled in Myanmar prior in 1824. The date of the first occupation by British. Despite generations of residing in Myanmar, the Rohingya are not considered to the amount of those official indigenous race. Are those effectively excluded from full citizenship? The criterion for citizenship is based on deeply flawed and outdated nation about the races and ethnic identity formation that were prevalent during the colonial period in Myanmar. The 1982 citizenship law is discriminatory on the ground, especially for the race and ethnic group. Since access to citizenship is primarily based on discriminatory on the ground of races and exclude certain races.
ຈັງລະຈັງລະໂອດູດີມັນໂດນະມານາຍງາລາຄະເນລະຕາຊິເລຊິເກໂຄເລວັນຊາບາເດຊໍລະຊໍຈິງຈັງລະໂອເນມານາຍງາຊາໂອຄວາງລາບັງລາເດດມັນດູອັນຍາດູເນດີນາຍງິເພດູບັງລາເດດມັນດູຍາດູຕະສລາຕະຊໍຊາງາຊິນຊໍຊິນຄຸນນະຊິນດູໂຄຍີທໍມະລາດາພິຊິມະລູບາດີລໍບາເດຊໍລາມໍເລຄິ
အားလုံးမင်္ဂလာပါကျောင်းရွှေလာရတဲ့ကျွန်တော်မြန်မာနိုင်ငံကကိုယ်စီလက်တော်ကြီးရခင်ဗျာအရှင်ကလူကြီးမမြင်ခင်ဗျာဒီကုလိုပြေဆုံးပေးရတာတော်တော်လေးကျွန်တော်ဝမ်းသာမိပါတယ်ဘယ်လိုခံစားရလဲဆိုတော့ကျွန်တော်သားသမီးတွေတောင်းကြတယ်တောင်းဝင်းစားလှုပ်ဖို့လာတဲ့မိဖလူပဲကျွန်တော်ဒီလိုခံစားရပါတယ်ကျွန်တော်ဒီမှာဘင်္ဂလားဒေ့ရှ်မှာနေရှင်လို့နေတာမဟုတ်ဘူးကျွန်တော်အသက်ပြည့်ကိုလူဖ तारो भाऊ चनो सिंधा रागा चनो जनरेशन अगो तू ने शिवी चनो कले रे सेडम सेडम जेमे कले रे तू या बाबा दे रे ना रे दी कले रे पिया रे बेमाले कना बिदु मा तावे जी ले रा दी कले रे ई पया ये बिदु मा तावे जी रे दा जिनु से महो बुला चनो ताव टोटली चनो वनी बार चनो तीन देवी जी चनो मी बार चनो आते ना से चो बिजरो चनो दे चनो जनरेशन दे बोलो लोमे दी जनरेशन दे मे माने इनगो प्यान लो छी ले दी पया मे रे नाइंगन लो पुंगे मे तया उपडे गो पुंगे मे दी बोले लुया ने भी फी तो ला मे दावो चनो का अधिक टा बारे दा चनो यंग जनरेशन अनादा तकुगा दी लोंगे रे जुलाई 27 28 ना दी चनो आ प्रोजेक्ट ने चनो पे के बारे अरे मां गजे हुए का नला चाबीरा लावे सो दिने जैसी मां लालो यार era go janoro selle biro era citizenship ki sai era safe security ki sai our another continuously dialogue ko ki sai janoro lopa ma go janoro keto ti mare selle biro diga di amya pya ile de tamai ma be janoro ga hop be myanmar nga lu ri yo asu ya go yu han ya so la me ka da me tamai go le la ji ba 1799, Dr. Francis Buchanan, Aluti, English decision, the Yoba. To go up here, you can be over English letters, or you can be over Yolare, you can be low, Mondo put it on, sit to a machine, Lurishire, Turugo, Turu, Yohinda Locore, Islamada go cooker, Lure, Belo Shile, the Gandoyan Shire. No Pira, Teno Lule, Mayagi, Tatonga, Lese Kuma. Teno Lima Upu de Buya Committee, Mashiki, Teno Yohanjani, Sultan Ames Sore Pogo, O Aduko Fort, Sore Pogo, Palin de Bell, Lulin of Mayati Wu. Dr. Mago Jiva, Teno Lulin, Tatonguya, O Senga, Senga di Teno, Nayata Point of Yaki, Teno Lugu, Amyadi Shira, Dinaki Shima, Lavira. Kemarin orang yang tahu mau buat supir ajar orang yang tahu bawa lebih lagi. Dan sih ini upu tego, itu sebile, dia suya le, punya dia suya, masalah suya. Era gua orang yang tahu, orang gua tak tahu ni apa. Dan saya di upu tego, korang implement malok tego. Sih ini upu tego, punya dia suya implement malok tego. Ebi lah, kalau wasil le lunga ni, kalau dia suya ho, siapa siapa lari. Dar puro le implement malok tego. Tiada demokrasi. Ya baraya siapa? Enam belas orang telah larian cerita kami orang kuat tak khayal luri. Memu payah bu supir tak khayal baca lomai dah. Enam cerita orang beli siapa? Beli mana? Dah aku tayar dah lah. Siapa sih? Pituara pituara. Eh, tamai aku cerita orang beli banyak aku. Pituara. Nama aku cerita ye luji menurunnya, nainya nolnya cerita data kenurunnya. Suhunya ina mira apa kita kugu sabu luri. Chang 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 ni dia, betul ni sih dia. Jadi, tak manisan lah. Aku pun faham sih ni. Dah awen, jadi pun faham dah. Kalau jadi ni, kalau sejak pun faham dah, sejak ni jadi ni sesen ba. Faham dah sejak ni jadi ini ba. Faham dah sejak ni, na lewa. Fitwa bi. Jadi aku hongo melayan ni. Jadi aku hongo belulu biro jadi aku accounting melayan lom melayan. Kalau aku weh, jadi lom sih ni. Tawabeh, tawabeh jenuh selebihnya, mana bila jenuh dahulah sinci amatiu, terawih jenuh power biro, selebihnya continuous jenuh lojin. We like to do something continuous itu with the dialogue, and the so thing is the history is the we forget. Is another is a new thing, to think the new thing and a new generation we would like to. Therefore, bila jenuh jenuh dah minum sop ada, jenuh luji jenuh le, si sinci baru le, menglawalu.
That remain in advanced state. And still there are fire. We don't want to listen to this kind of voice. It is, those people are your people. We are also your people. You must protect. But they are very unhappy, very upset for them. When our people are going to the hospital for medicine, for treatment, at that time, the doctor told, go, your father, ICJ, you will give the medicine. It is main example of the discrimination. We don't want to listen to this kind of word. Every time, every second, everywhere, informing like that. So, please create environment at first. And then, after creating a good environment, we will see. We have contract in Arakane state, and then we will see, and then we will go at once. No need to stay again, because we don't want to stay here. Everything is right. Bangladesh government providing everything, but our next generation is totally damaging now. How can we stay here for a long time? So we kindly request him at first. Create environment for everyone, not only for Rohingya people, but also the other ethnic, the Rakhine community. We have good communication with the Rakhine community. not any problem for a long time. But at that time, we don't know why they are doing like that. So, another thing, international community calling us as a Rohingya. When we arrived here, also Bangladesh and international community calling us as a Rohingya. When we arrived in Myanmar, at that time, the Myanmar people calling us a Bengali. So it means we have no name, we have no ethnic name, but ethnic name is the self-identity. According to the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, nobody can deny that. Rohingya is our self-identity. Bangladesh, Bangali is Bangladeshi identity. We are not Bangladeshi. If we use Bangladeshi's identity with Rohingya people, I think according to the universal law, it is a big human rights violation. So we requesting, please, at first we confirm our ethnic name, because why you are proposing again and again our ethnic name? According to the Myanmar law, all basic human rights are based on ethnic. For example, we have identity card, citizenship card. Also, other ethnic have the citizenship card. When we arrived to the check post, at that time they show. And they have two columns, race and religion. When they saw race, Bengali, at that time they don't go back. When they saw this Rakhine, you can go. It is main point of the discrimination. So please at first confirm our ethnic name, because of all basic human rights are based on ethnic. We are not demanding any illegal thing. We are demanding legal thing. As a another thing, we want to go home as quick as possible. Because of this is not our country. This camp area is not for human being. As you know, refugee life is don't want to stay here. That's a refugee life. But unfortunately, our luck is very bad. So our next generation are very damaging in the camp. So we don't want to stay here. So we requesting only one thing, please create as a convexing environment in Arakane state for safe return of the Rohingya. Another thing, as a gentleman mentioned here, when we will enter to Bangladesh, to Myanmar, we will must take the NVC. Main buyer of our Rohingya people for repatriation is the NVC. Because of, as we know, NVC have one formality procedure. There have some points. Number 12 and 13 have 2 points. Where and when we arrive in Myanmar. It's mean you are coming from foreign country to Myanmar, so you must sign that. It's mean we are not Myanmar national. We are newly coming here. So we are not newly people. We are original national of Myanmar as a Rohingya ethnic. According to our document that was provided directly by the Myanmar government, not any other one. So NVC is main problem for us. We are hopefully within ASEAN Art Center and also the Myanmar delegation will bring some new thing for us. But we don't know yes or not. We hopefully will be there soon, inshallah. Main issue, another thing, when we will go back, at that time you must stay in the 10-6 camp in Labu for 1 or 2 months. what is the grandeur of that thing? Because still in situ, 128,000 innocent Rohingya in concentration camp. How can we believe that? If it is right, we must go in your homeland after 1 month. It is right. Please prove that by doing something. It means please resettle at first as a IDP camp, their original homeland. And then we will ensure, we will believe we must go here. If not, our people did not understand that situation because of still IDP is remaining in Arakane state. So another issue is when our people are living in there, Arakane state, the forced labor is continuously happening now. Forced labor without any thing. Not only anything, but also not eating something. Every time, every second, informing us our situation is so bad.
The own country, no country can receive this kind of international security. You cannot find another place also. So, we discuss this one.
What I guess from the discussion with Arakane, the three major issues were discussed in NVC, the security and the citizenship. About the NVC, I think no decision came out about the security. Myanmar government is taking some measures because, you know, security and dialogue is not a permanent one. So they will also have something to do. And about the citizenship, they have shown us some pathway. I think this issue was also discussed for the last 2 years. And I think if they have something more, I think they can give us some point on that also.
Of NPC, we explain them to if they have process or show, they can show NRC or a 3-4 camp. They don't need to apply the NPC. NPC is only issued to people who don't have any kind of legal valid document. And citizenship, we explain them. Based on the 1982 citizenship law, we can address their issue effectively if we implement the 1982 law more efficiently. Security is an obligation of the government. The government we have explained that district commissioner of Rohingya explained the how he has facilitated the Muslim people who are down in the northern Rohingya state. They became crossfire between the AE and the military. And also, we also explain that the reason of the Iraqian the participation in this process, and also they ask about the equal right. We explain that this should be in line with the law. Equal right is including the property rights, and it should be in line with the law.
Thank you, sir. I think the best part that. What they have confirmed that they have mentioned, if you have any sort of legal document, a valid legal document, you do not need for NVC.
Mm-hmm.
Or tomorrow also. So we should finish it up here today, and we can start tomorrow's dialogue from here also, because we have come to a certain level, and they have given their views, you have given also their your views. It's not that this meeting will finalize everything. It will go on.
Just opening the window.
Okay. So I think I'm handing over the mic over to people to call it a day.
Thank you. As Mr. Director has cleared up, because the dialogue or the discussion, it is a continuous process. Suppose the ambiguity which we have today, maybe we will be able to have a suitable answer tomorrow, maybe. So, and it also might happen that tomorrow also we will not have the answers of the all questions. So since it is a continuous dialogue and discussion, it will be continuing. So hope for the best, and let us come tomorrow right in time. And after this, I call it a day. Thank you very much. Stay well.